Okay, there we go. All right, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Art in the Morning, Monday morning. And it is a nice bright day out, but I got the kind of, I didn't want this to flash out. So I do have the light turned down just a little. We might be readjusting it, but I think it's okay now. So I have a few different things to show and talk about this morning before we either do an art journal project or color book project, one of those two. Haven't decided yet. The rest of the week, my Cam and Boo are going to be here, and hopefully we'll do a video with them visiting. We'll see how the time thing goes, and if I can get one out of bed and one, you know. Anyway, so, but I do have some projects in the works for the new year, and but I'll talk about those in a minute. First, the most important thing is the new color book of the week. We have to have our priorities, people. And if y'all, and I am talking to a live chat, and yes, I've grown accustomed to your face, Julie. Oh, some of the girls, it is a live chat with live people here, and we have a full house this morning. Thanks everybody for being here. So if you're watching the recording, I'm not talking to myself. I am actually talking to live people in a live chat. So if y'all do have questions for me, put them in caps so that I can see. Hello, Stony Brook. And anyway, if y'all have put them in caps, so I'll know you're talking to me. So yes, Julie, I've become accustomed to your face. Okay, so the priority of the morning is the new color book. This one, I don't know. Paula, did Paula have this one? I'm not sure. I don't remember her having it, but I'm sure she's got it by now. We enable each other. Paula will get a new color book, and I hunt it up. I get a new color book. Paula hunts it up. We love our color books. Just saying. And Paula's getting so good at those color, that coloring and the shading. It's like, oh my gosh, we got to step up our game, people. Step up our coloring game. Anyway. So this is a Brothers Grimm. I found it at Books A Million. And it's like 8x8. So it's a little thick. Well, I don't know. I don't say it's thicker than other color books. But in some cases it is. It's thicker than like the Creative Haven ones for sure. But it was $14.95. Of course, I get discounts. And they always have sales and coupons and stuff like that. You got to watch for that. But I did get this at Books A Million. And it's a Brothers Grimm coloring book and other classic fairy tale. Escape into the world of fantasy and imagination. Adam Fisher is the, I don't know if he's the full artist or if he compiled it. I guess he did all the drawings. So it's really awesome in the sense that there's all different fairy tales. It came out this year, 2015. And so I'm going to flip through it, you know, like, and it'll have a little saying, like a quote from a one of the fairy tales and then the fairy tale it came from. Excuse me, guys. Like the first one here. The grandmother's house was out in the woods, half an hour from the village, from Little Red Riding Hood. So it'll have like a little quote and then from the fairy tale that it's from. You're drooling over this one, yeah. And they're one-sided, so if you are so inclined to take them out, let me see, yep, they are perforated. I had to feel, I couldn't remember if they were perforated. You could take them out, use them in an art journal page. You don't have to, you know, just like we did in the other options to use your color book page is to cut them out and put them in a, in your art journal. So you don't necessarily have to use everything, although if you wanted to expand on one or more of the fairy tales, you could make you a double page spread, you know, with part of it and draw part of it. And I got something in my eye. Collage some of it. So there's different. Yes, it is one-sided. Yes, it is good news. Yeah, I like the one-sided ones as well. Because, although, like the, where is it? My Doodler's Anonymous, I don't mind it so much being double-sided because the pages are thick. So I can use my water-based markers. Now, again, I don't know that you could use Copics or alcohol-based markers. But water-based markers won't go through this thick paper. So, you know, I don't mind it when it's double-sided like this if it's thick paper. Okay, but then you don't want to cut anything out of it either. So let me just kind of flip through here. And this, again, this is from Hansel and Gretel. I'm not going to read the quotes. I'll just kind of flip through and tell you some of the places that they're from. Okay. Cinderella, there's Cinderella. There's the Wicked Stepsisters, Snow White and the Poison Apple, The Little Mermaid. And I know it's kind of flashy. It's hard to hold it up to the camera and still get y'all to see. Let me lighten it up just a tad, guys. It's a little, I don't want to flash it out, but at the same time, I want you to be able to see. Okay, there, that's better. The Gingerbread Man. Some are more plain than others. The Pied Piper. And some have more, like, artsy detail. The Frog Prince. Thumbelina. Jack and the Beanstalk. I'm just going to flip through some. I don't want to do every single page because there's a lot. Well, there's Little Red Riding Hood, Hansel and Gretel. So I'm just going to kind of flip through here just so you can kind of see. You can kind of guess some of the fairy tales. Sleeping Beauty. So you can see it's awesome. Awesome fairy tales. Rapunzel. Another Little Red Riding Hood. So awesome. So just want to flip through real quick so you can kind of see. Hopefully you can see if I stay in camera. There's Cinderella and the Pumpkin Coach. But some, look at this one. Look how awesome that is. So they're just really, there's another Jack and the Beanstalk. So just going to quick. I mean, there's a lot in here. A lot. I don't even know how many pages are not numbered. I didn't count them, but there's a lot of pages in here. And it doesn't even, you could use bits of these. Like, it doesn't even have to be, like this castle. It doesn't have to be for Cinderella. You could use this castle in something else. Yeah, it's awesome. You know, you could use these fish, don't have to be, you know, they could be whatever. Now, of course, you know, this is kind of obviously Little Red Riding Hood. But, you know, a lot of it is not, they're not so specific that you couldn't use them in other things. Hopefully you're able to see some of these guys. I know I'm flipping through pretty quick. But to me, it was just like such a variety of things. Look at that. Isn't that awesome? So, again, you know, it doesn't have to necessarily be with the topic. Look at those birds. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that inking. So, let me just finish flipping real quick here. And I saw these. I flipped like two or three at a time. So, it's a lot of pages. A lot of images in there. Yeah. Okay, so that is a fun one for sure. So that's Brothers Grimm coloring book. And that's what it looks like. Again, it's 8x8. I did measure it. So that's, yeah, another fun one. Maybe we'll color something in here today, or maybe we will use some things I've got halfway colored that I can cut out and use in an art journal page. Because if I sit here and color this whole thing, that'll be the whole show. And then we wouldn't have time to cut something out and use it in a journal. So we'll have to see how it goes. All right, so I'm looking around. I have a few different topics and things to talk about. Let me put my glue away here. All right. So over the past couple years, I've done my fantasy animal posters. This one seems to be the favorite, and it is my largest one of the animals. Now, I do have a large scroll one with the whole scene on it. That's probably my largest one I've done recently, but it's not the animal, you know, it's not the animals. So this one happens to be 12, 14, 15, about 17 by 12. 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21 or so. And it's just a big, I had big pieces of paper and I cut them to whatever. Because I'm not selling the actual, you know, posters themselves. But what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to, these, you know, when I made them, I didn't make them to do anything with them other than to show you the techniques. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and revisit each one and retweak. Now, the animals are all my own paintings, but I do have little bits of collage in them, and I would not want to do any kind of copyright imagery in any of my posters. So what I would do is probably go in here and tweak this and paint some of this so that it's like either painted over. In this case, there's really not too much, like this flower is a cutout image, but it's not anything like very, I wouldn't think very copyrighted imagery, you know. These flowers here are all painted over. They're my own flowers painted over. He's all totally my own hand, you know. So anyway, but what I want to do is I will go back in probably and readdress each poster and then put them up on Society 6. So we'll see. That's my, like, plan for the first of the year. So I'm just going to show you the different posters that I have done, and again, they're going to flash out a little. I'll try to tilt them to the side so you can see how they flash out. I'll try to tilt them a little so you can see the true color, but if you really want to see the actual color there. Excuse me, let me take a sip of coffee. If you want to see them in true color, not flashed out, you can go look at my Twitter. My Instagram is probably the easiest to go see them, or my Facebook, any of those. This is the one that I use. All right, let me move this one just so you can see the size difference between this one and this one. Okay, this is the largest of them all. Then there's this size here. Whoops. Now, when I upload them, of course, you can... you can buy them in different sizes. They'll be available in different sizes, you know. This is the one I made my own postcard out of, just to, you know, for myself, you know, to send out with art and things, commissions and stuff. I made a postcard out of these to send to people. But this is the one that I use this bit right here as the header on my blog and my Facebook. Again, it's flashing out, but I think you get the idea. These right here are about 14 by 16, something like that. And again, sorry guys for the flash out. Would you really have to cover? Yeah, I would probably want to, not 100% necessarily, Janet, but yeah. So, but again, the animals are all fully, and all of this is all painted out, my own. But bits of watches and things like that, you know, I'd have to really, you know, think about how to do that. Okay, this one is a red panda combination fox. Because it was a red panda, but I kind of made it into kind of a combination of a fox. I made a beard with a, you know, tie. And then here's the little, this is all painted. But bits of the watch, like this right here, that's a piece of collage. The hands are all my own painting, you know, to make it look like a kind of steampunky kind of thing, see? So all this, again, sorry for the flashing out, guys. I'm trying to keep it with the out of glare, but, I painted a whole little world in there. So, and you've seen, I mean, I did most of these on stream. Okay, this is just a red fox. So again, there's not a lot of collagey stuff showing. A little bit of a watch here, but it's a general watch, and I painted out the name of the company. I would definitely make sure there was no like logos or anything like that. But it's kind of like they're not really, it's just, you know, a black face with white letters or numbers rather. So there's not really much to the collage that's usually left by the time I get done with one of these. But, you know, I would want to make sure and really look them over carefully. A big coffee table book. Yeah. Oh, my gosh, Vicki. This one is kind of not 100% done, but it's like the Alice Rabbit. Again, you know. Just throwing them over there. And so, like, this is some kind of a museum bit. Now, there's a watch on top, but that's like some kind of a statue, a museum statue. I don't have any idea. But, you know, I would want to make sure that I didn't have anything like that showing. I would repaint it, you know. Here's When Pigs Fly. She's got a little tattoo on her. So you can kind of see, this is all my own painting. And, of course, the animals are all my own painting. Yeah, I know, Jean. That's what I was just saying. Yeah, exactly, Jean. Okay, so here is my giraffe. So I'm just kind of showing them to you here. We've done most all of these on a live show. Now, I don't know that they're all on YouTube. A lot of them, probably the bulk of them are on YouTube, but you know, some of them are from before I was uploading to YouTube. Here's Hump Day Camel. Painted him looking like he's visualizing the beach, you know. And Squirrel in Space. And again, guys, sorry they keep flashing. I'm trying to kind of tilt them so that they don't flash out, but. You want to see the rabbit again? Okay, hang on, Liz. And then this one, Lisa named this one Space Odyssey. I don't know if Lisa's still here. But yeah, this one's Space Odyssey. I'm trying to see the whole thing here. So we'll see. That's kind of what some of my ideas. And then this one is the Four Horsemen. It's a little off of the topic of the fantasy animals, but it's the Four Horsemen. So you can kind of see. Again, it's flashing out, but all right, let's see. The rabbit. Where's the rabbit? Alice's rabbit, yeah. So anyway, that's thanks, Jean. So those are the ones that I just, like, picked out. There's a few more that are in process. I need something here for the camera to focus on. Get my something here. There we go. Keep it focused a little. I did brighten it up a little, so let's see. It's not wanting to. Let's get it to focus on something. There we go. Okay, let me see what things. So how about a calendar? Well, I don't know. I think I'd rather put them individually. Here's the thing about when you put them on Society 6. Now, I haven't researched it 100%, but from what I understand and seen, is like when you put an image on there, you can have it made into whatever you want. You can have it a poster. You can have a cell phone case. You know, you can have it a t-shirt. You can have it whatever. Well, I'm not sure if they do t-shirts. I'm not sure if Society 6 does t-shirts. I don't remember. I've looked at so many recently. But then you can pick the size you want up to a certain point, you know, and things like that. I can take bits of the animals, like just the animals themselves, for and crop that section for cell phone covers. In other words, like, I could take him, for example, and do this much of him, upload this much of him, and that would be a cell phone cover. That kind of thing. The lemur's my favorite too. That's why I use them all the time. Not in this vein. In other things I have, Janet, but not in this. I've been published, what, back in the 80s? I used to design for cross stitch companies. And so yeah, I've been published in my sketches for patterns. I mean, they're actual, I do the drawings and the sketches like I would draw something like that ant, like the rabbit, for instance, like this, let's say, draw him. And then I was, then somebody would, back then, this was before computers. Well, I gotta quit saying that. It's not before computers, before desktops. I'm not that old. But anyway, and then you would have to hand draw out. Let me see. And then you'd have to hand draw out, all graph out all these designs. And so, like, these are my designs here. Endangered species. So they start out like this, like a drawing, not with all the space stuff, of course, but just the animals themselves. So then they are graphed out to be like this to do the cross stitch from them, like this. And back then, every bit of this is hand done. None of this is done on computer. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Yeah, that's what how it works, Kathy. I would put it on Society 6, and you would buy from Society 6, and they would ship it. They can even frame things if you want them framed, or just send you posters, cell phone cases, whatever. You would buy from them. So I wouldn't have to worry about shipping or anything like that. Yeah, that's how it works, Kathy. Thanks, Julie. Pre-personal computers. Yes, thank you, Jean. Not before computers in like mainframes. Yeah, all this is hand done. Now, when it's hand done, it's not done this small. It's done it was more like I don't remember, it's in the 80s, but something like maybe a 2-inch square, and then on like a clay coated paper, and we had to use the technical pens that were a pain to clean out, the Kohinoor. Oh my gosh. Anyway, and you'd hand do every one of these, and then they take it, the printer would shrink it down and put it in the book. So we didn't actually have to draw this do this small, though a little bigger, but still every one of these symbols is hand done. And you can see how many symbols we would use to make it look realistic. Let me see if I can have a, is there a photograph of one in here? Okay, here's some of the finished ones. So you can see the detail. That's all stitchery. That's all stitched. So it goes from like this drawing to graphing it, and then somebody would actually stitch it for the book. So that's all stitched. So you can see how many colors are in them. So it's very detailed. So this is endangered. This is woodland wildlife. Same kind of thing. Every bit of that's all hand graft. So anyway, I just wanted to show you that. Yes, I have done this kind of thing for sale for books, but it ended up being something different than what you think. Anyway, so I just thought I'd share that. Okay. So the other thing that I wanted to talk about was, real quick, me and a whole bunch of different girls here color a lot and talking about different ways to use the books. So I love to cut these out and use them in. So I'm going to talk about some different people here. Let's see, where's the book? I'm going to talk about some different streamers and different art journalers and whatnot. Paula, are you listening? So anyway, We all have been doing art journals for the longest time. This is one of mine. Let me just find the one of the pages where I've used a color book page just for an example. So, let me find a page. I'm looking for a specific one. Because I have a bunch of them that have color book pages on them. All right, this is a good one. We did this one on a stream. So she's out of the flower fashion girl. So I colored her in the book, cut her out, and incorporated her into my own collage here, mixed media collage. And I love doing this. And this is my like favorite thing to do, other than like just if I like an image and I'll color it and cut it out and put it like... Put it like in my glue book here. Like here, let me go to the back one. That's the easiest. Like this. This one's out of the Paris book. And so I really like that image. And so I colored it. I cut her out and put her in my glue book here. And so I love doing that. Paula, it was awesome. She took, hang on, let me put this back. She took a color book like, let me find one similar, something like this. She took, I don't remember which one. She's done it in a couple different ones now. But like one of these books like this, like I think one of the ones she uses is a hardback too. But, and taken and used one side for a color book and one side for an art journal. And I thought that's awesome, even though, well, we won't get into that. some people didn't like the idea of like gluing things over somebody's color book. Well, you know, hey, it's a color book, people. You're the boss of your color book. You can do whatever you want. But I thought it was awesome that she would color one side and then art journal on another. Well, Romani, she just did a, and I just watched them last night, so I don't remember, a couple, 2-3 days ago is when she recorded. She would actually take the color book. How does she do it now? She did it a little different. Oh, I had it all mapped out of my head. Who did what? Well, anyway, she's taking a color book and turning it into kind of like a combination of the magazine journals that we showed the other day, where you white out the magazine text and things and put the color book. But I'm not sure if she's doing it in the color book or in an art journal. Anyway, what I was trying to get at, another color book you need. Yeah. So another thing for the color book is how you can combine the color books and your art journals, whether you use a color book to add art journaling in, whether you do half and half, whether you cut things out of an art out of a color book and put them in an art journal. So my point was, is there's multiple combinations for the different ways. But I thought it was awesome that Paula had used a color book and made it into an art journal. And you know, I just like to use the color pages in the art journal. But anyway, so make sure you watch Journal Artista Paula and Romani's. She just did a couple of Ustreams uploaded to YouTube as well with her version of doing mixed media color book everything. And so disclaimer. Yeah, I know, Terry, right? So anyway, I don't know if Paula's still here, but anyway, so yeah, watch both of them's versions of using color book pages in an art journal or using a color book to turn into an art journal. That's what I was trying to say. Oh, yeah, you're going to need, Bridget goes, there's so many options. I'm going to need a bigger boat. I got to write that down, Bridget. That needs to go in the Wingnut book. Hang on. Let me put that in the Wingnut book. So if you don't know what the Wingnut book is, it is a book with funny quips, quotes, and sayings people say during the stream. They won't mean anything once you get past this. But on journaling ideas on journaling slash color book ideas. Bridgeton. I am going to need a bigger boat. That's a reference to Jaws, if y'all don't know that. Okay, so that's, so I just put, write them on post-it notes and they all get stuck in the wing notebook. The wing notebook is getting quite full and there's no dating. It just all gets stuck in there randomly. And I said before that when Denise was here, my daughter was helping me like reorganize my room. She went through this and was reading some of them and she went, what? That doesn't even make any sense. Well, it doesn't make any sense now, but it doesn't, you know, it's one of those you have to be here. Okay, Paula. So anyway, I put that in there, Bridgeton. Okay, so the other thing that I wanted to talk about in using the using your just, it doesn't even have to be color book involved, but your mixed media collage. And I know Paula's been jonesing after this one painting of mine forever. And somehow, I don't know why I didn't give it to her when she was actually here, where she could have just put it in her suitcase and taken it home. Shipping paintings is risky when they're international. Paula can't even get her stencils to her house. But anyway, there's this one painting that Paula's always liked. Anyway, so what I wanted to say is that Ro was talking about using her art journal pages and paintings. And when she was saying, I go, yes, you can. I'll show you, Ro. So I'm going to show you some of where I've used art journal pages to turn into paintings. Now, I don't think any of those, these were I did these on Ustream probably 4 years ago, maybe five. I don't know, because I've been streaming for five. Paula's been streaming for over five. But I've only been uploading to YouTube for the last year. So anything prior to that is not on YouTube. So these paintings will not be on YouTube. But I wanted to show you how you can take your art journal pages and turn them into paintings, using them as like your sketch, okay? So let me just kind of move this right up here, and I'm going to show y'all some. Now, the two, I think two, including the one of Paula's, I don't remember what book they're in. The original collage that I did, that I based the paintings off of, I don't remember what book they're in. Okay, so I'm just going to have to show you the paintings. But I'll show you some of the ideas and some of the ways you can use your art journal pages if you're so inclined. Now, these are on canvas board. If I did these again, I would do them on like heavy paper, you know, probably hot press watercolor paper that's smooth, not the cold press rough, but the hot press. I would do it on, I have all kinds of different papers, thick and thin and Bristol and all that, but I would probably do it on a heavy, let's just put it that way, a heavy paper rather than on canvas boards now if I was going to do them again or start doing more of them. Hey Carrie, I would start doing them on heavy paper rather than canvas boards. For a couple reasons. One, it's very hard to ship and very expensive. But that's just me, you know. You can, if you're just going to do them for yourself, you can do them on whatever you want to do them on. You know, whether it's a board, it could be a, you know, the stretch canvas. I personally do not enjoy working on stretch canvas. I don't like the give of it. And I know there's ways that you can, you know, prevent, I don't enjoy it. I have done stretch canvas paintings with oils, but I don't enjoy oils either. So I just prefer, working on paper anymore. Okay. But I want to show you some of the canvas ones that I've done just to give you an example. So here is, some of these are in my art journals, and I don't remember which art journal. I've got a whole shelf here of probably hundreds of journals. I can't remember where every single one of my ideas have come, but they're out of my journals. This is a mixed media collage piece I did, and this is just the photograph of a section of a collage. I did. I love this section. So I did turn this into, and again, they're not varnished, they're not 100% finished, but I keep them more for samples anymore to show you that you can take your mixed media work and turn them into paintings. So here is this is all acrylic painting on a canvas board, and I just used cheap Michaels brand ones. Okay, so here you can see where I took this bit of lock and key area right here and a little bit of space and turned that into some clouds there. And so here is I'm going to turn it a little sideways. So, and again, it's there. It keeps wanting to flash out, but there, that's pretty close right there. So you can turn them in to your paintings. But I gotta say, guys, this isn't just like you whip these out like you do your mixed media, okay? You know, we have been doing these for a long time, can, you know, put out a mixed media double page spread, sometimes a whole book, pretty quick. Right? We can do that pretty quick. But painting, and this is all acrylic, painting is gonna take you longer. You're not gonna just whip one of these out in a day. I'm just saying. But I keep this, and again, this has not been varnished or anything because I try to keep a few of these for samples to show you what can be done. Okay. Another one, and again, I did a art journal page, and I based this one. I liked to think of this as Darcy UK. So this is a painting that I based on Darcy UK with her red pink hair. And again, it's a canvas board, and it's based on one of my mixed media collages. Just kind of make a stack here. This one, I wish I did have, this is a good one to show an example of, because this one looks almost exactly, let's see, what a, so tricky to try to remember which journal they're in. Let's see here, probably one of these two ringed ones. Let me check this ring one here. I don't think it's in this one. This is one of my earliest ones on Ustream. Ah, it is! This is one of my earliest ones on Ustream. So here is a double page spread. Again, I despiral all my journals and I just put book rings in them to hold them together. I don't like the crunchiness of the paint in the spirals. So I take the spirals out and just use book rings. But it just so happened I remembered this one here. So this is one of my older streams. And this painting, this mixed media collage right here. Let me see if I can get the whole thing. Again, this one is like, what's the size of this book? It's a 12 by 14. So, but this painting right here, and I think, who was it that really liked this one? Was it Linda or Julie? I can't remember. But anyway, so this is the mixed media collage. So there's bits of collage, and then there's bits of painting, you know, mixed media. Well, here's what I did with this. So here's the painting that I turned into that piece. So you can see this all painted acrylic. Okay, so like this little bit of border down here, which I have to turn sideways. See, that's a little bit of a mixed media, like cut off of a frame or something. It was Linda. That was like some bit off of a gold leaf frame. Well, here's my version of painting it right there. So anyway, this one to me turned out to be the closest that I've ever really done. One of the closest, let's put it that way. This is one of the closest. And I did different glasses. I put cat eye glasses on her, you know. Anyway, so, but it's one of the closest that I've ever done from a mixed media turned into a painting. You like seeing the older pieces, Vicki? Yeah, it's been a while since I've pulled these babies out. I don't think I've pulled these out, these paintings out in the last year. I don't think. Okay. So anyway, yeah, this is one of my older journals, and I put a piece of scrapbook paper that looked like a door, and these are real hinges. These are paper hinges But I put brads in them to make them look like metal, you know. Anyway, so this is one of the older journals. All right, here's one. Again, I don't have, I don't know. Let me look real quick. It might be in this one. Let me look real quick to see if it's in this one. I don't even remember what all is in this book, to tell you the truth. But let me see if this next painting is in here. I'm not thinking it is. I think it was an individual. Wait. It is. Okay. We're in luck today. All right, here's another double page spread. This right here, I wanted to turn into a painting. That is not finished. Okay, so this painting, the girl is not, her face and all is not finished, but you can still see the idea. So here's the painting, and here is, I mean, the collage, and here's my painting based on it. Okay, again, she's not done, but you can kind of see where I'm going with it. Okay. There we go. So it's I get crack-a-lacking on something during a stream, and sometimes they don't get done. Oh, good, Trina. And hi, Trina, by the way. And Trina, I did get your email, and I have not had, I've read it, and I didn't want to just give you a quick response back, so I just haven't answered you back yet. Okay, so again, let's see what else I have here that might be in this book. I'm not sure if this one is in this book or not. This is a smaller one. Let's look, let me flip through the book and see. I don't remember this one being in my journal here, in this particular journal. Again, I don't remember which every journal that every piece came out of, so I don't think this one's in. This is a smaller one. Let's see if I can get it to not flash. Then I've got a couple more samples here. Like, here's a mixed media collage. I just want to show you how you can take your paintings, your mixed media collage, and turn them into your own paintings. All right, so here's like mixed media collage here. So let me just try to pick out the collage pieces and my painted pieces. So there's a part of a watch, that's collage. The bird is a collage. And this arch right here is the top of a bit of collage. I turn this into a bridge. A little bit of weeds behind the bird. And then the rest of this is paint. The mountains, the clouds, the water, the sky, that's all paint, okay? So I took this and I turned it into this. Let me get the flash out. So you can see it doesn't, it's not exactly like the watch, but it's I try to get, the idea and the concepts in there. See, again, there's the bird. There's the bridge down there. So you can see it's not exact. And I turn this into a heart. I turn that into a heart rather than just a bunch of weeds behind them. I thought it was really cool to just make a big heart, like he was like a flame. I kind of made it like fire and a heart. And he's like, so anyway. So you can kind of see, I got to turn it sideways. This one's been varnished, so it's going to have a glare. So you can kind of see how you can take your mixed media. And again, this is not quick. I could do 10 of these in the time it takes to do one of these. It does take time. It does. No, these are on canvas board. This is on paper. This is out of like one of my art journals. This is just, this is cardstock or out of an art journal or cardstock one. I don't even remember. And then I put them on here. Now, again, but what I was saying though is if I were to do some more of these, I would do them on paper, like I'm doing my fantasy animals. I would paint them on paper, like heavy, Bristol board or something, or smooth watercolor paper that's heavier, rather than on the boards. I just enjoy painting on paper more than I do canvas boards. Okay, so there's that sample. Here's another one. Again, this one is not done. We did this on a stream, and sometimes you just don't have time to finish everything. Okay, so here's one of my mixed media collages. Okay, and again, it's flashing out, so you're going to have to kind of, you know, work with the flash there, but let me see if I can get the camera to pull back. Because it did get kind of whited out. There we go. Okay, so there, sort of, is another one. I can't make a decent collage. You're trying. Well, it does take practice. You know, and I've shown you how I did. I've done hundreds of hours probably, Suzanne. Most of, you know, half my streams are collage. Okay, so anyway, so here is the mixed media collage. And again, sorry guys, it just flashed out again. Let's see if I can grab it. It's wanting to see if I can get a black section there. Still wanting to flash out. And so here's the painting that's based off of it. Again, I think we got about halfway done. See, none of this is done yet. So I did this in stages just to show you how to do it. But it's not done. As you can see, this is not near finished. But you get the idea. Okay, there we go. All right, here's the one that Paula Paula loves this one, and I don't know where the collage is for this, but this is the one that Paula's always loved, and I don't even have a date on the end of, back of it, but here's the one that Paula loves, and this one's been varnished, so it's going to have a glare to it. Let me turn it sideways. Anyway, this is all hand painted to make it look like the bits of wood frame. I think it was a wood frame. I think it was a wood. I did this one in 2011. So we've been knowing Miss Paula for a long time. Okay, so anyway, she's like sitting on a shelf and then like kind of like a stylized bit of watch there. And again, it's, you know, it's been varnished, so it's shiny. But this is the one that Paula wants. See if I can get her face to. Yeah, they can kind of see. And her hat's made of bits of watch parts and metallic things. She's kind of steampunk, kind of, a little bit. Anyway, so there's that one. And then the last one I have here to show you is my version of Columbus. I did this one for a Columbus Day thing. Let's see what years. This was 2011, too. And this is a large one. And again, it's been varnished, so it's going to flash out. But, so you can kind of see. I did a compass rose. I'm going to turn it a little sideways so it doesn't flash out on you. And then here's the bottom. There's his hand holding. Oh, let me go this way now. I'm trying to keep it from flashing out, guys. There's his shawl, like a shawl. So, again, this was based off of a, there we go, based off of a collage. Oh, thanks, Rain. Yeah. Hey, Camera B, it's been a while since I've seen you. So those are the mix. Those are paintings based off of your art journal pages. Again, I think that if I were going to do any more of those, I'd put them on paper. It's just for me, it just seems easier to work on. I'm talking not thin paper. I'm talking, you know, heavy paper rather than board. So anyway, so those are some of the ideas and tips for using your mixed media collage in a painting. So any questions on that? And before I get started on any kind of project, I'm going to run down and get some coffee. I know it's been too long. I hope you're doing well, Camera B. Hope you're doing well. Anybody else? Hey, Blondie. Anybody else popping in here? Let me check who I might have missed coming in. Thanks, everybody, for being here. I'm hoping Carrie, I'm hoping you're okay, Miss Carrie Pixie. I haven't seen you over the weekend. Hey, Karen, Billy Karen, Orla. Who else am I might have missed? Brina. I think I've said hi to most everybody. Thanks, everybody, for being here. Green Glams. I'm just kind of scanning the list of everybody here to see if I might have missed somebody. Thanks, everybody, for being here. Shirley. I said hi to Lisa and Tammy. Thanks, guys. Lots of anonymous. Thanks for being here. Oh, I was just making sure you were okay, Carrie, because you weren't around that much over the weekend on the social media. Just checking on you, Pixie. All right, let me go run down and get some. Oh, let me show you again real quick. Because I know I'm sorry. I'm proud of my grandchildren. This was done by my grandson. This is one of his drawings, and he does use Copic markers and color pencil. And I'm going to show, it's probably going to flash out, but I put it on my iPad. I put it on the iPad because it flashes out less than my phone. But this is one of, oh, hang on. Let me get, this is one of my grandson's drawings. And I know the camera light is there. So, anyway, I'm real proud of him and his artistic abilities. All right, let me go down and get some coffee, and then we'll do either a color book or, maybe work in the mixed media journal here, adding a color book page or something. So I got lots of stuff, lots of, empty, this is just a play. I'll add a little bit here, a little bit there, a little bit what. I know he's good, isn't he? So here's some of the fish. In this case, the only thing that's part of a color book are the fish. So that was fun to do, the little fish, and make it look like, a whole little world for our fish. And I've shown this book a whole bunch of times. It's all in different, the different pages are in different stages. This one needs some work. I like the colors here. And then some just don't really have anything but some paint and stencil. Here's the steampunk, one of the steampunk ones. I'll leave it here while I go get some coffee. So just give me 1 second, guys. Go get some hot coffee so my throat doesn't get sore again. Okay. Oh, feels good. Nice hot coffee. Yes, he's 16. He just turned 16, and my granddaughter just is getting ready to turn 13, and they're going to be here tomorrow. So maybe sometime, maybe Wednesday morning. I don't know who's streaming. I get new people are starting to have schedules. And I don't want to overstep anybody that's plans on streaming on any of these mornings. I know I plan every Monday, but other than that, I don't have plans. I do impromptus, but maybe because Thursday, of course, is Thanksgiving. Friday, we go get the Christmas tree, and then they're probably going to be ready to go home. But so maybe it won't probably be tomorrow. Maybe Wednesday morning. I don't know. Yeah, I'll see. It's going to be hard to get Cam up. I'm looking over at the color books real quick. It's hard to get him up because he's a night owl. He will be up drawing until 2 o'clock in the morning and still get up and go to school at 7. So, hey, Uli. Okay, unknown number. I don't know anybody in New York, so I will not be answering that. Sorry, guys, you have to listen to that ring for a second. But anyway, Glorious Gardens. Oh, let me just take the phone out here. All right. I keep it close to me in case Hubster calls, but he's not in New York, so. Yes, he is definitely a late night jammy journaler. I'm going to tell him you said that, Vicky. He'll get a kick out of that. He is a late night jammy journaler. No, Boo is just getting ready to turn 13, Rain. And then my other grandson out in LA is 6. So, yeah, that's right, Vicky. All right, so this one is another one of the Omara Press books. And as is, this is the same company that puts out Anamorphia. I keep wanting to say Animalia, but it's Anamorphia. The same one that puts that book out puts this one out. And it's all Glorious Gardens. And I love this for cutting out, I got to say. So I usually have to pick a side that is the other side. I don't, unless you know, make a copy of something. If something's really double-sided that you just absolutely can't imagine cutting up both sides, I don't usually have that problem because there's so many to select from. So, but anyway, something like these flowers, there's all kinds of like birds and designs and gardening things. But these are all great kind of things to cut up and use in your art journal. Like this right here, that's awesome right there. I guess that's supposed to be a bumblebee. Let's see, one wing. I guess the other wing's on the other side. But that's awesome to put in a book. Now, a couple different things you can do, and I've shown you in here. You can cut your things out and glue it in and then color, which I don't recommend, especially if you do mixed media collage, because let me find one here, for example, where I've done just a bit, where there's just the not colored yet. Okay, here. So this is out of the Angel book. So I cut this out and then and glued these, and this is out of the one of the Celtic books. And put it in here. Now in this case, it's pretty smooth. I don't feel the collage much under it, but if you're going to do color pencil and detailed color pencil work, if you've got collage under there, you're going to have like a ridge where the collage is underneath. You know, I can really feel it if I try, and but your pencil will feel it. So if you go to color this after you've glued it in, you're going to pick up the bumps and lumps of your collage underneath. So I don't recommend doing it. What I would recommend doing is if just tacking it in with like a just a little tiny bit of a glue stick, just tack it in the space you want while you're planning it out. And then you can pull it out and put it on something else to color and then glue it in. But I'm just showing you all different kinds of ways you can do it. These fairies here were cut out and then glued into the book, okay? And then I have different mixed media collaging and painting and whatnot going on, some clouds floating over the top. So you can do it in many, many different ways. So what I was going to say, though, is I would recommend doing it in the book, because then you don't have to worry about going out of lines. If you cut this out first and then start to try to color it, your edges are going to start to curl. Your pencil's going to run off the edge, and it's going to be easier. Let's just put it that way. It's easier to color in the book or take it out of the book. I don't think this one's perforated for some reason. This one's not perforated. So let me be careful. I would recommend, you know, just coloring it on something. My desk is all crusty and bumpy. So you don't want to, I could feel every bit of the bumps and lumps in my table through this. So you want to make sure you're working on something that's perfectly smooth. So I'd recommend like just doing this and then cutting out, because then you don't have to worry about even going out of lines. You just color right over the edge because you know you're going to cut it out. All right. So I'm thinking maybe let's find a page. Okay. A couple other things. I'm trying to get all of the information in at once. A couple other things is you can color this first and then find a home for it in a book, in one of your art journal pages, or you can find a page that you want to match the colors. In other words, like let's say we want it here. I might want to color him in colors that coordinate with these pages here. So you can do it either way. Here's the other steampunk girl. And we added our own little feathers. When I say we, it's because when I do something with you guys here, I think it's of us as we. So these little feathers have not been glued down yet. So those are like out of a calendar peacock picture or something. And I just gave her wings. She's out of the steampunk book. Again, I'm going to have to prop this up so there's less glare. Let me find something to put under there. A couple other color books to prop this up a little. There we go. So you can do it different ways. So if you want to use something like this, like maybe it would be kind of cool to use it in these kind of the purple. She's got some purple and this cabbage that's kind of a tealy green. Maybe some of this orange, burnt orange, and do this flower in those colors. And again, just because you've colored the whole thing and cut it out and made it to match doesn't mean you have to use the whole thing. I could cut this out and just use a little bit of it and cut it off. Okay? So you're the boss of your color book and you're the boss of your journal. Don't let anybody tell you can't color over something. You know what I mean, Vern? So I think what we'll do is we'll color this flower and this bee in these colors. I might use some paint and some pencil. And then maybe place it somehow down in this area. It could be upside down, right side up. But just because of I like that flower and I want something right here. Again, let's see if we can get the... let me see if I can focus that back in. Hang on, guys. Keeps wanting to flash it out. There we go. So any questions or anything? You like the steampunk? Yeah, I like her too. And Ro did an awesome double page spread. Well, she's working on a wolf one too. She didn't finish, but she did the girl and she's working on the wolf. And then, but the other pages, she did a steampunk girl. It's not out of this book. It's out of the new one. I think it's out of the new one. There's two steampunk ones out, Creative Haven ones, and she did the first page. She used one of the girls out of the steampunk book, then she drew her own girl and did a background. It was really awesome. Thank you. Yes. Thanks, Eileen, for linking that. So Paula's stencils. Yeah. So if we're talking about stencils here, we use some stencils. Paula has Eye Stencil Girl. It's not Eye Stencil, it's just Stencil Girl. Stencilgirl.com, and Paula Journal Artista has some new stencils out with them. So again, these kind of things, you know, you use as backgrounds, but if you're just stuck for some kind of focal image, use one of your color book pages or more than one. You know, this is out of a different, totally different book. This one is, Trina, is the Creative Coloring for Grown-Ups Glorious Gardens. And it's put out by Omara, the same people that put out Animorphia. And they have a new one out too, Menagerie, I think is what it is. So here's some different, and it's animals as well, but I believe it's by a different artist. I haven't seen it close up. I've not seen it in person. Here's some more flowers. Again, started to cut out, you know, just to show. We did that on a stream. There's some koi fish in there. So instead of maybe not using all the lily pads and everything, you might just want to use the fish and cut them out like we did the clownfish on the other page, the other journal page. And you know, or you just might want to relax and color the whole thing. Here's some pretty roses. That would be good on a, where is it? these roses right here, those would be awesome to color and cut out for a journal page. Okay, so, and I try to show all my color books as I buy them. I'm trying to just get one a week, although sometimes the weeks closely overlap. It might be every 6 days instead of a full week, but anyway. I do have a color book folder on Facebook, and it's public, so you don't have to follow me or me follow you for you to go see my color book album. They call it albums, you know, whatever. You can just go in there and look under my albums, and I have separate albums for my color books and color pages. I have another album for my Gold Rush crew drawings. I have another one for just general, my portraits and all that are in one, and they're all public, so anybody can go look at any of them. You like the koi page? Is that what I, did I say koi or did I say goldfish? I don't even remember, but it's koi. Yeah. Thanks, Reid. So, hey, Colleen, anybody else popping in? All right, so that's what we're going to do. I think we're going to color this to kind of go with this. All right? So I'm going to probably use some acrylic paints as a base. And I might do two or three colors in here just because I want it to tie in with this. Again, you don't have to tie it in with the page. You could just color this and then find a page later that it goes with. Or you don't have to use, you know, you can just cut this out and put it like I did in my glue book. The girl from the Paris book that I showed you, the back of her, I just like that image. So I just cut her out and glued her on a white page just because I liked it, you know. So do whatever makes you happy with your color books and your, hey, Whippy. Hey, Princess Buttercup. Hey, Princess Buttercup. All right, so I think that's what we're going to do. Let me bring my water over here. Let me get my water tray over here close. And a palette thing or two here. So, hey, Sarah O. So, anyway, hope all y'all coming in are doing well. And, yeah, so I just want to show using a little bit more of your color books in an art journal page. Again, this one's not done. It's still in progress. Bit of collage. This is all color, mixed media, stencils, paint, scrape paints, all kinds of things going on here. All right, so I think, though, I'm going to want to start with just some kind of shake it up here. I'm going to just put out a few of the colors that I want to use. That one's almost empty. I'm going to have to refill that color. A burnt orange. Don't I have it here? Or do I have to go over to the... Let me go over here to my cart. Need a burnt orange. And I love my Americanas. Those are my favorites. Just craft paint. A little... burnt orange, a little, what was the other color? Oh, purple. Now, which purple do I want? Maybe a little of both. Let's put a little of both. This is purple pizzazz. And this one is, I'm shaking them up as I go, dioxazine purple. So just a tad. Don't need too much. Just a little. This one has a crusty bit in the lid. Let me get the crusty bit out of the lid because I don't close my paints like I should and I don't have Boo here to clean them out for me. So let me get the crusty bit out of the lid. There we go. You get it? I think so. That one's kind of old anyway. Probably not much left in there. All right, now I gotta get a baby wipe, clean my hands. All right. Can you do something about the end of the, go ahead and point it at the head. Not really. Do you want me to put a flower in there? I creeped you out. Oh. The steampunk book is probably not for you, Whippy. All right, let me just put a little bit out. I think that's probably just not much left in that one. All right, so that's creeping out Whippy here. Hang on. There's a bit of a... There we go. There we go, Whippy. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I don't want to get this too saturated. I'm going to try to keep the paint pretty dry because it's not thick like the, Doodlers Anonymous book. It's not, what color book is this, the bee from? It's from the Glorious Garden. Okay. And so we're going to color it to kind of match this page because I want to use it right down here. Okay. Or I might use half of it here and maybe part of it up there. And then I'll incorporate the rest of the imagery in with paint. You know, kind of make it a... That's okay. We'll put up with you, Whippy. You're welcome. All right. So let me just grab a brush here. Let's see. Oh, it's kind of a small one. Let's go with kind of a small one. No, that's going to be too... Let's see. Let me get another jar. I just have a few right here. I've got other jars of brushes. I'm not seeing what I want in here. Let me get another jar. I really want an angle brushes are my favorite. This is not angled, but my angle brushes are kind of crusty. I mean, they're not really crusty because they're clean. I keep good care of my brushes. But after a while, they start to flare. Let's see. Try another jar. Hang on, guys. I need something small, but not round. Ah, here we go. Something this small. This is the kind of size I'm looking for, as opposed to that. All right, so get my brush damp. Just so if you damp, get your brush damp, then it prevents paint from drying inside the brush. We'll do a calendar. Do a calendar with your e-gods. Oh my goodness, you girls. Hi, and hi, Colleen. I hope you're feeling good today. All right, I have no plan. This is just, you know, I am going to try to kind of wet down a little bit, but I don't want it soaking wet, but I'm just kind of like just getting it a little bit of water just so it'll flow. But I don't want to saturate this, although it really won't matter if it wrinkles too much because I'm going to glue it all down, you know. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the inside of the flower. I'm just going to do the whole inside of the flower, this kind of, and I know these flowers are not these colors probably in real life, but that's why we're the boss of our color books. All right. So what I want to do though is I'm going to get most of the paint off my brush, and what I want to do is just kind of pull some of that paint while it's wet into the petal like that. Again, it's going to depend on what your use is as to how much water you might want to get on this. If you get too much water, it's going to buckle. If that doesn't bother you, then don't worry about it. But if you're not going to glue this down in something and it's going to buckle, it probably will bother you. Really, Paula? Okay. Well, I can show you all the brushes. Yeah, I guess it just depends on how... I just pick a brush by what I know in my head I'm going to do. Now the next thing I'm going to do is go on these larger petals, so I might take a larger brush. But I never really think about that. I guess I just assume everybody just picks whatever brushes they have, you know? So let me wet that brush. And now what I want to do is go in with, let's see, what do I want to end with? I think I want to end with the purple. So I'm going to go in here with the blue next. So I'm just going to kind of pull out. I might need just a tad of water, not too much, just to kind of get it flowy. And I'm going to start from the other end now. And I'm just going to go all the way around and just kind of, I'm going to kind of blend the two. Now, I say blend loosely. I'm not really blending. I'm just kind of getting the colors on, because what I'm going to do after this, guys, is go in here with color pencil. So I'm not really overly concerned here with it being smooth like you would get with a Copic or something, because I'm going to go over it with pencil. Okay. But I might need to water it down just a little to get it to kind of flow. And I might want to pick up some more of the orange and pull some more of that in there if I want it a little bit more dark. Okay, so just something like that is all I'm going to do. I'm not making this too complicated. It's not complicated if you don't, unless you know, if you want to do some real heavy details, you know, I just happen to do those heavy details with pencil. So this is just kind of almost like a background. Okay. So, and I'm just trying to get all the colors that I'm going to use in here. So it doesn't look like much yet, but you know, wait for it, Vern. And again, we're going to cut this out. Now I'm going to take some of the dark purple, and I'm just going to, I've got to wet it down because this is an old paint. It's a little more dry than the others. Now, as long as I can see the black line where I'm going to cut, I'm just going to go right over the whole thing. I'm just want the I want the darker purple all the way around the edge. And as long as I can see where I need to cut, I don't care if it goes out of lines, because I'm going to cut it out. All right. Just a little darker. So it's just something you can do. Again, earlier I was talking about Paula Journal Artista's techniques that she uses in her color books and art journals, and Romani, she did a use stream. I wasn't able to be there at live, but I watched the recording on her journaling and combination journaling and color book techniques as well. So we all are just kind of like, you know, using all different things that we combine together to make it whatever we want it to be, because we're the boss of our color books. Okay, so let's see. Chit-chat here. Oh, good. Good, Colleen. Colleen, I guess, can start. She had to have surgery on her foot, so if anybody's listening, that's what we're talking about. But she's going to be able to walk on Wednesday. A new Friedman painting in your coloring books. Yes, for sure, especially if you're going to cut something out. All right, so oh yeah, I want to do something. I can't really I think, do I want to put a little yellow with the B? Do I want to, let's just go ahead and paint a little bit of the yellow in there. And I'd have to really look at a picture of a B again to remember which sides are which. You know, I kind of want to, let's just put a little yellow. You know, because some of the B's colors are very specific to the stripes of them, but I'm just going to put a little yellow on there. You probably can't even see that, but just to have something on the B. All right, so now I'm going to take all this. Let's just go ahead and do this real quick, because I don't have a desk journal per se right now. I haven't been doing, anytime I'm using some leftovers like this, it's usually in this journal. Let me just put a tack, good grief, the gun's bothering some people. Let me just kind of put a little bit of, just to tack that down on the gun. So I can turn the pages. All right, so what I want to do though is I want to use this up. So let me get a palette knife and just find a page where I want to use that up. Usually it goes in my desk journal. It goes in where I can just scrape paint and then maybe make something with it later. Okay, here, let's just take some of this purple here and put some of this purple in here. I'll just get, use some of the purple up on this page again. can do that, and then just take a baby wipe and you can smear some in. You could leave it very, what do you call it? Palette knifey. But this is how you can use stuff like this. Now, again, this is wet, so I want to hit that with a heat gun. But I want to use up this paint. So let me just kind of put some of that down here. There's a little bit of that yellow in there, too. I might pick up that little bit of yellow. A little, because there's yellow inside of these bearded irises. So that little bit of leftover yellow. So that's what you can do with your leftover paint while you're thinking about your next steps. Just use it in an art journal or a desk journal or something. All right, let me hit this with the heat gun. Oh, I got to plug it in. Hang on. Heat gun. Hey, Marita. I just want it dry enough so that when I close it, it's not going to stick. Craft paints usually do not stick your pages together as long as they're dry. I got a little bit of something to glue you right there. As long as they're dry, you can, you know, they usually do not stick your pages together. Okay. Yeah, my heat gun's probably, how old are these, Paula? 20 years? Paul and I have these original Marvy Uchida heat guns. They knock on wood, well, you know, whatever. They have lasted for so long. All right. So now that's, oh, so let's go and see if I can, all right, here's a page here where some of this blue will work. I'm just going to put some of that in here. I'm trying to use up this paint, you see. Maybe some of this, a little bit of that burnt orange. I'm just scraping up what's left. I'll put a little bit of, tiny bit of purple down here because it's kind of all the same colors, actually. In this page that it has in the other one. And then this will be backgrounds for other things, whether it's a person, you know, whether it's something I draw, color, whatever. So I used up the bulk of it. I didn't use up every smidgen, but I used up a bulk of it. You could actually dip your baby wipe in the tray in your palette and pick up all the excess paint, and you can get rid of all of it. So, I mean, if you want to use it up. You know, so I'm just going to kind of just blend in some of these areas. Turn the baby wipe if you want a clean area. Put some of that purple up there. Some of that teal. So just a start for a background. Again, all this would be totally blended out eventually. Like, let me take some of this. I mean, I would totally get rid of all edges. If I'm going to use this background, so you can see how you can get rid of every smidgen of edges. And again, I repeat the same tips over and over, and everybody says, no, we want to hear the tips all the time. It's better if you tear out your collage elements rather than cut them. Like this is torn, so this is going to blend a lot easier. Now I need a little more purple. It's much easier to blend out your collage edges with torn edges than it is with cut edges. They just blend out easier. So you can kind of see. I need a little more. Now I'm going to get some more teal. We're already on to another page here. Oops, that one's almost empty. I'm going to have to restock up on some of my paints. So you can see how those are gone. All right, so watch this one now. Same thing. We're gonna. So if you want to see him disappear. Did he use Neo 2s not long ago? Yes, I did. I used Neos on it too. So I'm not sure what you're talking about. I don't fixative anything. I mean, I don't on my journal pages that have only acrylic, I'll seal them in my art cards too. The little art cards. If it's just acrylic paint, I will varnish them with that Indoor-Outdoor Delta Ceram Coat Gloss Varnish. But it's only if it's totally acrylic paint. If you've got Neo colors, watercolor, even color pencil can smear off with the Ceram Coat Varnish. I don't do any sealing or spraying or anything. There's a glare right there. With other mediums. Yes, I make the edges disappear. Let's put a little blue up here. It's a little too much. Let's pull that back a little. So there. See, it flashes out, guys. You got to kind of give me a little leeway on the colors because they do flash out. And there's a glare right there. Okay, so let me dry this. Let me get a fresh baby wipe to clean my hands. And now this one's ready for another something. See, I already see a whole little world down here. There's a cave right there. There's like where the land comes out there. Something's sitting right there. Could be a little bird sitting there. I don't know. There's a little world there. I can see another arch here. Okay, so let's dry this. So as far as putting a varnish or something, I mean, you can spray seal things, you know, with fixatives and spray seals, but I would definitely test all that with, you know, a sample something first before doing it over a finished piece. You wouldn't want to do a whole Neo Color 2 background and some collage and some other things and then go and varnish it and it all smear. So you want to test out whatever you seal or varnish. I just know that you're safe. If it's all acrylic paint and collage papers, you can varnish that safely. Okay. But you want to make sure your pages are dry before you close them. And then craft paint, you don't usually have a problem with your pages sticking. Now, some of my books have been smashed down with the weight of 10 other books on top of them. And sometimes when I haven't opened them in a long time, you can hear them going, you know, sounds like they're ripping things off, but they're really, it really doesn't. They sound crunchy, like they sound like they're tearing something. But if it's just a craft paint in your, in your collage, they might sound like they're ripping something, but they're really not. It's pretty safe. Even after they've been smashed down with the weight of 10 other books on top of them. But you do want to make sure it's dry. Like there's a little bit of wet paint right there. If I close this now and it dried, it would probably peel, you know, pick up. Not that it matters so much in this, but if you're doing something really nice that you didn't want ruined, you want to make sure it's dry. My napping Gary. Oh my gosh, girl. All right, so I think that's dry now. All right, so so there's where we used up the rest of that paint. Let's go back to our steampunk girl. Where is she? Well, she must be further up here than I thought. was it toward the back? No, it was this way, I thought. Where is she? Where are you, girl? Where are you? Don't think it's this far forward. All right, let's find her. She's hiding from us. Really? I can't tell if I should have put a post-it note in there. Making sure I'm not... There she is. Okay. All right, so back to this. If you have any questions, put them in caps. It's funny, Carrie. Must be all that mind mapping. Okay. So now I'm going to put the paint away. Let me get the jar of water out of my way. Also, be knocking into that. And let's move all the brushes. All right. All right. She skipped town. Who skipped town? Somebody skipped town. Where someone needs to make a wanted poster. So who skipped town? I missed something. Who skipped town? And who do we need to make a wanted poster for? I missed that. All right. So. Oh, her? All right. So now what I want to do, did I dry this? I don't know. It still feels a little damp. Let me hit it again. I'm not sure I dried this. The steampunk girl, yeah. Yeah, okay. All right. So again, it's a little curly. Not too bad, you know. But anyway, is that paint on there? I'm making a mess. All right. So let me get some... color pencils, and I want some couple of shades of these. So I'm going to want my sienna or terracotta, sienna color. I'm going to get a, here's a kind of a little bit of magenta. Might be a little light. Oh, sorry guys. I always catch my hair clip on the stick. All right, let's see. Let's get some purple. Let's get purples. Let's get violet. We want the dark purple. I'll have to sharpen that one. And maybe, I don't know, maybe I want this purple. Is that a different purple? No, it's the same one. Okay, so we'll use the one that's sharpened. And that kind of magenta. A terracotta. Probably a brown, a dark brown for shadows. Here's the dark brown. A little bit of... for the bee, we're going to do a little shading of the bee. Where's a yellow? There's a kind of a, it's too dark yellow. It's too green. Okay, here's a bit of a yellow. Might have to find another yellow. I'm just pulling colors here, guys. All right, and then now the teal colors. Dark teal, probably a white. Don't know that I'll need black, but we'll pull that too. Okay, so we're going to go with these colors. All right, so people always ask me the colors. Not that it really matters, because unless you colored these exact colors of paint, these exact colors of color pencil are not going to matter. But I'll tell you what they are. Hey, Ella. There are places... I mistakenly had them sent to you. Oh no, Sarah. Did they forward them to you? Sarah had a whole bunch of color books sent to her old address because her old address was on Prime. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. They were forwarded to you. Thankfully, the opponent is also our friends. Okay, good. Okay. They arrived safely. All color book emergencies have been averted. Sarah. All right, so I have black and white, dark brown, which is in one of my pencil extenders, I think this yellow needs to be in one too. That's just like a plain yellow, which I'm going to have to sharpen. Then I have the, I think it's goldenrod. And then I have the ochre. And then two shades of purple. I got the mulberry and the violet. Then I have terracotta and the peacock blue. So, and did I say white? Yeah. So these are the colors that we're going to use. All right. So let me sharpen that yellow. I think everything else. This yellow, I think it's kind of down to its last bit. Let me use a different sharpener for this. It's down to the last. I mean, look, that's still pretty pathetic, isn't it? Is that my fault that I'm not sharpening it right? What do y'all think? You know, people say I don't sharpen my pencils right. What do y'all think? Am I sharpening that wrong? Or could that possibly be something wrong with the wood? I'm going to find another yellow. That one's doomed. All right. So let's see. I need to, let me see which colors of Eileen, you know, my Luminance? I keep wanting to say Luminance, but I think it's Luminance that I could maybe use in here. Let's see. I know yellow's in here. So Eileen gifted me my Luminance, Caran d'Ache Luminance. So we're going to just mix it up. Yeah. I mean, I don't see why we can't do that anyway, right? Now, again, I don't have enough here to do my portraits, and she's trying to enable me to buy more of these. But we do have the yellow. We have a, so let's just use as many of these as we can. We have a yellow and an orange kind of, well, I don't really want orange. I want more the, they have a version. It looks yellow on here, but it's kind of a, what do you call it? Kind of a ochre color. So we're going to get rid of the yellow here and the ochre and the orange. We'll use these colors for the B. Okay, so we have colors for the B. We don't have a teal, but we do have a terracotta. There's a terracotta, so we'll get rid of the terracotta here. What else can we replace? Purple. What purple do I have? The dark violet. So we're going to get rid of, oh, that's the dark brown. Wait, here. We'll get rid of the violet and use the violet here. And again, I'm not sure if that's the color. They have numbers. Okay. And then a dark brown. Let's see. The dark brown. I better test this one. I can't tell if it's a purple or a brown. Okay, that's brown. So we're going to get rid of the dark brown and replace it with the dark brown. So I think the only color, okay, white. Let's replace the white, the black. Where's the black? I know there's a black. Am I using the black in something else and I have it pulled? So that's not black, I don't think. That's dark blue. Where's my black? Oh, already, that's what it is. I pulled the black. That's black. Okay, then I need, let's see, dark brown. Got dark brown, black, the yellows. Oh, I'm needing a purple. I'm needing a purple because that was black. Maybe I don't have a dark purple. I might have to go back to the dark purple. Got the light. This is a mulberry. I don't have a match for that. Oh, wait, what's this color? Oh, that's kind of maroon. Sorry, guys. You're just going to have to bear with me here a minute. Okay, where's my dark purple? I think the only thing I need back is a dark purple. Dark purple. There's the magenta. Where's the dark purple I just had? I threw it over here and now I can't find it. It's violet. Where's violet? One moment. Looking for the violet. Now, just put it in a tray. It can't have gone too far. Ah, here we go. Yeah. All right. So, there we go. So, I'm going to use part Luminance and part Prismacolor. There we go. We're set for this flower. Oh, questions. Are you ready for Thanksgiving? No, we're not. No, I just get new pencil sharpeners, Trina. When they if they stop really sharpening, I just get a new one. I've got probably 20, 25 pencil sharpeners. I do want to try, I gotta say. Some of the girls have talked about a couple of the electric sharpeners I use that are not grinding their pencils down to a stub. So I just haven't had a chance to really go shopping for that. It doesn't matter, Uli. They just to be honest with you, they don't care. Okay, so let's go ahead and start with. I'm going to get the terracotta. I do have. I'm a little in the dark here because I'm trying not to flash out the pages, but it is getting a little dark as the sun has now moved over the top of the house. Yeah, exactly, Vicky. All right, so I'm going to get the dark. Wait, what is this? Is that black? Okay, let me get my dark brown. Here we go. And what I want to do now is, and let's try to zoom in a little. Let's just go for it. What the, we're gonna live large. We're gonna just zoom in here and hope for the best. All right, let's autofocus. Get the color a little bit bright, just a little brighter. There we go. All right, there we go. All right. All right, so I'm going to take the. Now, this may not be a dark enough brown for the total bit that I want to do. I mean, it's dark. It's almost like a medium brown rather than dark, dark brown. And there is not a dark, dark brown. There's an umber, a burnt umber, but it's too gray. I don't want the gray in the umber. So let me compare. Yeah, see the how that's just a little bit darker. So I think I'm going to go with the Prismacolor dark brown to get under each one of these little puffy bits in the middle of the flower. Coffee. Yeah, boss stitch. Yeah, thanks, Suzanne. It's a boss stitch electric eraser. I mean, electric eraser. Oh, well, there's those two. Electric sharpener. All right, so I'm just going to shade around all the different little. And again, I'm not going to make this like it has to be some kind of a masterpiece. I'm just, we don't want to be here all day on this one flower. We're already an hour and 40 minutes in. This is just now getting to a project. But hey, you get lots of tips and techniques and things like that. All right, so I'm just going to kind of that. All right, but I might want a little highlight, so we're going to go with it. Let's pick up our white. Oh, I got to kind of move. Let me move down a little here. Stay. And I'm just going to maybe highlight, I just sharpened it, so there's a little crusty bit on the very tip. I'm just going to go in here. And you could do this with like a yellow or something. I just want it to show up. So I just want this to be like those little. The little fuzzy pollen. That's what I'm thinking, the word pollen. I want it to look like pollen. Pollen. I want it to look like little pollen bits on the inside of that flower that the bee is going after. So there we go. Now that you zoom the bird, I saw it turn into a bee. Oh, you thought that was a bird? Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sorry, Julie. Just a little pollen. Now I might want to shade a little bit under behind that. I'm going to lightly shade under the bee. Doing it light because then you can blend. Okay. Excuse me. That sounded like I was going to burp. Don't want to do that. That was a fake one. I didn't really do that. We Southern gals have all that class. No, it was Paula. Yeah, Paula. It was pollen, not Paula. Paula. All right. So anyway, where's Vicky? I need. There she is. I knew. I had to get a ROFL. Oh, that was for Paula. Okay. So I'm just kind of, pulling out a little bit of that dark brown under there, underneath, on the bottom side of that. Right, so now I'm going to go back over to the mid-tone brown. Let's test that out. It needs to be a little bit more. I think I'm going to go with the terracotta now up here, just to have a little bit of shade coming out of it. That. I'm just talking it out. I'm not, this isn't really exactly like, oh, this is a class. Now pick up this pencil. You just got to kind of watch along, guys. It's just kind of a watch along. But take notes if there's something you want to see. Go, oh, I got to remember that. If you don't write it down, you'll forget. But see how the paint is kind of making it look washed out before it goes into the other color. All right. So and this edge are the darker, and I want it to kind of be. I want the petals to be the blue to kind of go light to dark, the purple to go light to dark. So for instance, let me go ahead and put a little bit of white here just to kind of lighten up these edges. Although technically, I guess the petals wouldn't be light here. Well, maybe they would be. They're going to be in my world. In my world. Because you know what? I'm the boss of my color book. Thanks, Eileen. Yeah, the white is awesome. Illuminance is awesome. And I'm not trying to make it pure white. What I'm trying to do is just kind of blend those two edges together. Just kind of get them a little bit more, softened where I had the paint. So you can see that acrylic paint is a great base for color pencils. I got to keep coming down this way, so don't want to get off camera. All right, so that's kind of enough for now, I think. Maybe a little bit on this side. I'm not trying to make this white. I'm trying to just make it light blue, light teal. See, I'm just trying to lighten up the teal a little right around there. What I'm kind of doing is like an ombre kind of thing. I'm kind of trying to ombre these colors out rather than a harsh line of color. In other words, I don't want this petal brown, then that row blue, then that row dark blue, then that row purple. I want them to kind of all kind of blend out, kind of ombre out. Yeah, Midori. Paula has a real Midori, the leather one. I have a faux Dory and the Adori Bulls, which are basically a faux Dory as well, that Sister Woman made. And she is going to be having those back in her shop. And I've had a couple people ask. I got some brown on this wing there. I don't want the wing to have brown in it. Let me see. Maybe I should have erased that. Sister Woman, who is half of the Scrappy Camper Sisters, she will be, if you look on her blog, Scrappy Camper Sisters, I think .blogspot or something like that. If you put in it doesn't have an eraser on it. If you put on, if you look that up, you'll find her blog. And she's going to be having new Adorables. Somebody's messaging me on my phone. It's in the other room. Is it important? Is somebody messaging me? Is it important? My phone's in the other room. Anyway, and I'm using to erase. Nothing ever erases completely. Hang on, guys. I don't know what that is. It might be Denise. Just a second. And for the person that said, it bothered, don't worry about it. It's no biggie. I got like 5 messages in a row, right? From different people. I had totally different random messages. Okay, I totally forgot where I was going. All right, we're trying to ombre this out. Where was I going? What did I? I forgot what I was talking about. Hey, what is crack-a-lackin'? Oh, what's crack-a-lackin'? Yeah, Tina. Yeah, we're crack-a-lackin'. I'm coloring this flower out of this book to put in an art journal page. And I'm really zoomed in right now so you can't see the art journal page. Oh, the eraser. That's what I was going for. Okay, so nothing ever really totally erases, but the Ticonderoga Black with the black eraser, to me, works the best to get rid of as much as you possibly can with an eraser, other than maybe an electric eraser, which probably, you know, get right down in there. Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Trina, and yeah, thank you, Suzanne. So that's what I use for erasing color pencil. And again, you know, by the time you get five layers on, you're not going to ever get back down to the white paper. Just saying. You know, you can paint over it. If you get something really horribly wrong like that, I could actually go in there with some white paint and paint that little bit out, but I'm not worried about it. It's going on an art journal page. But if with white, if you want to shade some white, use either a gray or a gray blue, and that makes a great shadow for white. And in this case, it's kind of a clear, you know, wing. But I just want to put a little bit of something on there. So just a little bit of a gray blue is a great shadow like that. That's, you know, then maybe just take your white and kind of just blend it in a little bit on the edges like that. That's all I'm going to do on the wing. Just leave it like that. Although technically you could probably see some yellow through it because it is see-through. Maybe just a touch of yellow, and which probably doesn't show up. You like your electric eraser? Yeah. I would read all the guys in my day. Are the Ticonderoga just regular? Yes, they're just, no, the Ticonderogas are regular, just number two pencils. But I like the black ones because of the black eraser. But they have the yellow, just school pencils. Well, they're both school pencils, basically. But I buy them just for the eraser. Cam likes to draw with these. He likes to draw with the Ticonderoga. My personal favorite, just if I'm sketching for my personal self, is just these. These little Pentel disposable. Because I sketch light if I'm going to be doing, unless it's like a sketch at the museum or something like that, or the aquarium, then I'll use my... I know I got one here somewhere. I know there's one sitting in this tray. The woodless graphites. Well, I can't find one right now. It's probably off to the side somewhere. But the woodless graphites that put down a nice big area of graphite if I'm sketching. If I'm actually out sketching, drawing something, and, you know, out sketching somewhere. Oh, I know I gotta find one here somewhere. I'll have to pull another one out of the drawer because I got tons of them and I just showed it last week. Anyway, because it's got a thick, a thin, you know, you can, the whole thing is graphite. So you can do shading on the side, get thin, thick lines. But if I'm just gonna draw something out that I'm gonna paint or whatever, color pencil or whatever, I'll just use this because it's very little and light. So if I'm going to just draw something out, you can't hardly see it on camera, but I would want to just sketch something out very lightly, then I would just use this. Yes, I know you do. One of these days I'll get those, won't I, Vicky? All right, let's get back to our color pencil here. But anyway, all right. So I have all of my pencils that I'm using right here. And I'm using a combination of some of my Prismacolors. I don't think I'll need this anymore because that was the only place I wanted to get some gray shadow down. But I'm using a combination of the ones that Eileen sent me in the Luminance set. Okay, somebody messaged me again. Whoever it is just going to have to wait. All right. This is the box. She sent me a box of 20. And it's awesome. And they work just as fine. They work fine with the Prismacolor. They play well together. Although I have to say, these don't break. They sharpen perfectly. But they cost $5 a pencil. So, you know, you got to kind of balance it out. So I'm using the colors that I possibly could out of her set. And then this, the one colors I don't have, like a turquoisey, dark turquoise, then I'm using the Prismacolor. That, a dark brown, a black. I know I have a black one too. Oh, here's my, is this my black? Oh, I keep wanting to see the word black on there. They just have numbers. They don't have, oh yeah, it does have the black. Yep, that is black. Okay, it's just hard to see. My poor eyes would not be able to read that without just the direct lighting. All right, let me do this. Let me pull out my black and white and set it here to my right so I can get rid of the black Prismacolor out of this little set or out of this thing here. All right. One day, Vicky. Okay, so let me sharpen this. Good luck. Wish me luck on the sharpening. Okay. All right. That broke. Sharpening, breaking. Sharpening, breaking. Okay. I don't know who this... Hang on, guys. This is irritating me. Sorry. The girl, my two daughters and Hubster are all in a group. We're all in a group message. So we're all in individual messages and we have a group message. And they're messaging each other. And Hubster and I are in that group that they're talking about a restaurant they're going to. So they're talking to each other. And I'm just included in it. So that's what it is. So now that I know what it is, I can ignore it. Oh. Okay, yes, they play well together. It broke again. All I did was do that. Oh. Prismacolor, you're losing my loyalty. Just saying. Broke again. That's the fourth time it's broke while I'm trying to sharpen it. So this pencil is obviously, look at that. Look how that's sharpening. Can you, look, it's crusting off. And it's a centered one, too. Okay. Yes, Miss Allie, I'm going to use this in an art journal page. I'm just too zoomed in right now for you to see that, but yeah. All right, so what I want to do, oh my gosh, I'm having to use like an edge. It's horrible. So what I want to do is just kind of blend in some of the purple and along the edge there so you can kind of see, because I'm trying to do kind of an ombre thing. So I just want to lay down a little bit of the blue. Oh my gosh, it's literally crumbling under my hand. I'm barely pushing on it, it's crumbling. Anyway, I'm trying to get just a little bit of the blue down. Then I'm going to go back over it with the purple to kind of ombre it out. Kind of, can y'all kind of see that? And then I want some of this to be a like part, like mid-tone right in here. So I'm basically trying to ombre. Sharpen the other end. Yeah, I could try that. But if it's broken all the way through, it's not going to matter. I'm going to go on at eBay and find me some old barrels is what I'm going to do. Some old barrel Prismacolor. The old, it was Barrel, then Sanford, and then Premier. Premier is horrible. Okay. I mean, I love the waxiness of it, but the quality control of the wood, they changed the wood. They just changed the wood somehow. When they went to Premiere, I don't know what they did, but anyway, so you can start to see how I'm starting to get an ombre thing going. Well, I don't have a choice right now, Trina. I can't afford luminance, and I think that's what they expect. People can't afford the real expensive pencils, so these are like the best you can get in the mid-range. All right, I sharpened the other end, which was hard because I'm having to sharpen over a glued down sticker. I'm gonna have to get my knife and cut that off. All right, so anyway, enough complaining, enough complaining. I'm just going to add another little bit of blue into the purple there. I know, Vicky. I use mine down to nubs. I use my barrels down to like smaller than, oh, here's an example. I use my barrels down to this big. And then I gave all of them to Cam, and he hoards these nubs. He has a big plastic bag full of my nubs. He hoards them because he knows himself being, because he likes doing Copics with color pencil, and that's what he uses too, Prismacolor. And so he hoards those nubs. Oh, but we already think them. Yeah, I know. Well, everybody go buy them on eBay. There won't be any left for me to find. Go for it, girls. Oh my gosh. So if you're listening to this, if you're watching the recording here, we're just kind of, well, I am anyway, fussing about the low quality of the premieres. They're not like they used to be when they were barrel. Okay. So I got a little bit, you can see I've got a little bit. Now I'm going to do the same thing on the edge here with the purple, the dark purple. Did I have a dark purple in Eileen's? No, that was the brown. Okay. So I'm going to take the dark purple here, and I'm just going to go along the edge here too. And then I'm going to start blending everything together because I want it to ombre. I'm trying to get it to ombre. Oh. And if y'all missed it, I have a bit of a color. Acrylic paint is the base of it, and now I'm going over that with the color pencils. And then we're going to cut it out and put it in the art journal. Hopefully before 30 more minutes is up. Yeah, and Ro, I was talking about you earlier too, just saying. To go back and watch if you weren't here. Talking about your art journals and stuff too. I'm giving you a shout out. I have tried the color soft. The Derwent color soft to me are not as good as the regular Derwent. And now I don't know. I've had these for a while, Ro. They're called Derwent Artist. They are much better than the Derwent color soft. Let me find one that has. You can see the writing on it here. Derwent Artist. The color soft are scratchy. To me, you can feel them scratchy, but these Derwent Artist, I like them much better than the Color Soft. I have a few of those. I'm not the Chromos, they're okay, but again, personally, I like the Derwent, not the Color Soft, the Derwent Artist is what's written on the pencil. So I don't know if they. I don't know the situation of which pencils have the ColorSoft replaced the Artist ones. I don't know. I haven't kept up with it, but I guess I should be, 'cause I ain't too happy with my Prismacolors these days. So, So what we're just doing is taking a bit of a color book page. I put a water, I mean, a acrylic wash on it, and now I'm going in and trying to do like an ombre on this flower. Then we're going to cut this flower out and put it in the art journal page that we have picked out. We specifically picked these colors to match the art journal page. So there. All right, so now I'm going to get, did I have a purple in yours, Eileen? Oh, it wasn't the right purple, was it? It was too lavender, I think. All right, so let's go with this, the mulberry. Is it mulberry? I think so. Anyway, so again, I'm just trying to work, and I'm going to put a light coat here because I can go back in there with white to kind of make lighter, lighter purple and lighter, lighter blue. But I have to have something for it to blend. So if I don't have this magenta color on here, I won't get any of that color because I'm not going to, just because I put white over the top of the paint isn't going to blend. It's just going to put white like that, like the pollen bits. It just put white on top, okay, of the paint. If you want to blend with the white, you have to have color there. You have to have pencil to blend out from. I don't know if that made any sense. It didn't even make sense to me. But you do have some of the artist ones coming. Yeah, and Jess loves the polychromos because they're not waxy. But that's what I like about the Prismacolor is the waxiness. So I guess you just get used to something, you know. And, of course, Jess uses a lot of, she uses Copics. So maybe the polychromes are good for the Copic as well. You know, so, I mean, they're okay. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying there's, you know, it's just that I'm so used to the softness of the Prismacolor is what I love. Bye, Mella. Okay, so there we go. Now, so you can see we have the dark purple and this like magenta. Now I'm going to go in with the white. And you'll see how I can kind of get, I'm going to try to kind of hit each petal now to kind of sort of start get a little bit of an ombre petal thing going there. Like, hope you can see. I don't know. So I'm kind of, with the white, I'm blending the two purples together right there. Kind of make it an ombre-like with a little bit of highlight on it. Then I'm going to go back and do the blue. I just skipped over the blue and went straight to the purple. And I'm probably putting a lot more effort into this flower than I normally would, throwing it into an art journal. But because I'm doing it on stream, I want to show kind of how it works. You know, put a little bit more effort in it for the stream. Hope you can kind of see from there to there. Okay, now let's go the other way. But I'm not trying to make it, I want it to look more like, you know, like I said, the ombre rather than each petal being colored in a certain color. I want them to kind of ombre. That's the only way I know how to describe it. You can see good. Thank you, Vicki. It's always good to see you guys, especially when I don't see some of y'all for a while. It's always nice to see. Pull back up here. I'm putting very little pressure. I'm not bearing down. Very light pressure. Very light pressure. And the lighter the pressure and the lighter your layers, the more you can blend. now I'm going to keep going up here with the blue. Maybe a little in there. I'm probably going to cut some of that off, but we'll... And I know people say, well, do you ever use a blender? Do you ever use the, you know, there's the markers that you can buy that have like, I think it's just mineral spirits in the markers to blend. And I just don't. I don't like putting things wet on my color pencil. But that doesn't mean that you can't try it. You might love it. You know, I just don't. But that doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with using any of those, you know, mineral spirits. And I've even seen people talk about using baby oil. I personally couldn't stand the feel of putting baby oil on my paper, but that's just me. Yeah, this white is good. This white Luminance white is cool. Very cool, Jess. So I'm just kind of, you know, light touch. Just want to kind of ombre in, you know. So you can kind of see I've given it a faded out look. And I could take more time and, you know, really get in each petal a little bit more definitively. But I want to finish this up before my time runs out, before the 3 hours. And technically, it's like 2 hours and 50 minutes. I mean, again, I can always start another show, but I don't want to stop. I don't want it to stop mid, you know, project like this if I can finish it. So anyway, you can just continue on just blending this. And let me see. I do have a color just to show y'all. There's one here somewhere. Succinct. Okay. Yeah, now this is from the Sanford days. It shows you how I don't use them. This is the Prismacolor Colorless Blender. And basically what it is, it's the waxy stuff without any pigment in it. And this is back from Sanford, which is before Premiere, but after Barrel. I don't even know if Barrel made these. I'm not sure, because I never really use them. Let me sharpen one up here. To show you what it looks like. But it kind of feels like rubbery. It's kind of rubbery like, and it's, I guess, you know, supposedly the same stuff. I don't know about that. It's supposedly the same stuff that the waxy pencils are made out of, but with no color. So you use them to blend, and so you can push a little harder. Let me get rid of that. You can push a little harder and have them blend, have your colors blend. But to me, it just makes it like a waxy build. It makes the wax come to the surface. And I don't like it. It's kind of scratchy. I don't enjoy it. I don't enjoy blending with these. I'd rather just blend with pencil. But just FYI, just to let y'all know that it's out there, that you can get these. And again, but it does pick up. Look. See how it picks up the purple on the end? So if you're going to go from like purple to white, you want to make sure over here off the side and clean off the tip just like you would a white pencil. Otherwise, if you pick up the purple here and you go here on the wing to start blending, you're going to put that purple down right there. So always check on your light colors, especially your light colors, to clean the tips off. Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome, Terry. Glad you got it. So anyway, like I said, this is back from Sanford. I don't know if I'm sure they're out there, but I don't know if they're, I guess they'd have to be Premiere now since Sanford is no longer around, but that just shows how old that one is. Okay, so let me clean up some of this. So I think I'm just going to stop. I could keep blending, some more of the blue here needs some more blending for the ombre. But I'm going to stop now because I want to cut this out and glue it in the journal. Because I want y'all to see that before we leave. But you can see it can still use some more blending. You could go back in here with the blue and get in some more areas and kind of keep working it. Keep working that ombre look. So it's usually never ever a one-time application, and then that's it. You know, it's usually multiple coloring, multiple layering, multiple blending. So I'm going to go over some of those blue areas. Have you used the Prisma Art Sticks? No, I haven't used those, Ro. I guess because when I'm using color pencils, I'm in there for the detail. And the Art Sticks, just like, you know, supposedly it's the same pigment. Paula has some, I think. It's supposedly the same pigment stuff on the Art Sticks that's in the pencil. But most of the time when I get in there with color pencil, it's for the detail. So a big Art Stick, probably just, you know, I'm sure there's uses for it. But when I'm doing a big area, say on the background of an art journal or something, it's usually paint. But I'm sure there's uses for it. I just haven't really had a felt the need to get them, you know. Maybe you need to do a show on that, Ro. All right, so I think you got to get the idea here with the ombre. So I'm going back over some of the blue with the purple. And just trying to make it like ombre out is the best way I can describe it. Again, I could put a whole nother layer, keep it with the blue, you know, to keep on, get it more and more refined. And go back over it with some white again and blend it in. Or just take your time and just keep blending with the pigment, I mean with the color. All right, so I'm going to stop just because. Oh, I didn't do anything on the bee. Hang on. Let me get a little bit of the orange here. I just want to put a little bit of something under the wing. Okay, I'm going to stop just because I'm going to run out of time. But you get the idea. I could have a little bit more of the... A little bit more shadow under the wing, say. And I'll show you some of the pages I've colored in the last week or so, too. But anyway, it needs more blending, but you get the idea. All right, so now I'm going to move this out of the way. Get me some scissors. And I'm going to fussy, well, here, let me go ahead and back out now because we're going to be gluing. Let's see. Yeah, the paint gives it a tooth. Let me cut this off because it's going to be in the way. That you just, you can't get with what, I mean, you can get a tooth. You can get a, honey, you can get yourself a tooth. You can get some tooth with the Neo colors and the watercolor. Remember, I did that chart for you guys. Oh, of all the different things that you could paint under your color pencil. But nothing makes it as vibrant or as crisp or as... It just doesn't work as well with anything other than just craft acrylic paint. Oh. All right, so I'm just going to cut this out real quick. I think every time I cut with some scissors, I think of Boo when she went to pre-K. And, you know, she's used to using these. She's used to using my, like, the Timmy, you know, like, where are they? You know, she's used to using scissors like this, you know. And she's used to using, you know, Eileen's tacky glue and stuff. So she goes to pre-K. She's probably 4, you know. And she had, they... And back then, you bought the supplies and you took them to school. And the teacher would like gather everything up, and then when you needed your scissors or your glue, she'd hand it out, you know, so it doesn't get wasted and lost in people, you know, the kid's desk. So she goes to cut her first thing and glue her first thing down in pre-K, and they give her these those rounded kid scissors, and she looks at them like, what am I supposed to do with these? She's used to some points and getting in there, and, you know, she's used to this, you know, cutting with this. And then when they gave her the school glue, she went, where's my Eileen's tacky? Because she grew up, you know, she grew up using, you know, this kind of stuff, not kid stuff, you know. She doesn't use, don't give me none of that kid stuff. Okay. All right. So let me put, wait a minute, before we go on anywhere further, we're going to put our pencils back in their home, because these pencils, they have a home that they live in. Each one has their own, let's see, the white, oh, I got the, oh, the white goes on this side. Yeah. They each have their own little room. These pencils are too dang expensive to throw in the thing. Okay, I'm missing one. Oh, there it is. All right, there we go. So, yes. All righty. Are we ready to move on yet? Do we pet for a minute? We're going to pet. All right, so thank you again, Miss E-T-E-E, Eileen the Enabler Elf. She gifted me these, and so I treasure them. I am using them, though, Paula. I'm not just treasuring. All right, so here's the art journal page. It's a little flashed out. We have the, where's Whippy? Is Whippy Carol still there? Can we take the cover off the gun? Oh, yeah. Well, it's not velvet. It's not velvet, although the lid, hang on, let me take the top off. The lid is velvet. The lid is squishy. Well, it's not really velvet, but it feels like velvet, but it's squishy. It's padded. It's padded velvet. This is the foamy, the kind of foamy. It's a little softer, but it's like velvet. Yes, it is. Oh, you're still here. Okay. We'll keep that on there for a minute then, Whippy. Now, when we're gonna remove it shortly, but it'll be toward the end. So we colored this flower to fit the colors of this. Now, I gotta say, looking at it now, the purple looks a little bright. Maybe it's because, you know, I don't know, but anyway. So I'm thinking about how I want to use this. I'm going to cut this white part off, but I'm just going to see how much I want to use. And you can use bits of, like, it doesn't even have to be the whole flower. So let's just see here. Let me cut off this excess white. Let's see where I want it to be. B. Okay, so I want the B to be down here. All right, but I don't want to waste these colored bits when I can just, I'm going to take and I'm going to like go along the edge here. Okay, so I made an indent. Okay, so I'm going to save that to use. Let me get it all the way to the edge so I can just use this much of it here. Just because I like it. But we have this little bit of flower left here. So what I'm going to do here is take that bit and probably tie it in somewhere up here. Like that. Okay? So it's not just in one place. Because it's a little bit off color. You know, it's a little different color. But I might add some more purple up in that area. And I know it's flashing out. Let me prop this back up again so it's not so flashed out. Still flashed out. Now, when I go to just glue extra pieces like this in my journal, you know, most of the time, you know, before I get any other, the collage bits are usually done with matte medium because I can paint over them. With the matte medium, if your collage bits are painted or are glued down with matte medium and you go over it with paint, you can wipe the paint back. Okay. I did not matte medium these down yet, but I'm just going to glue these down too. So what I'm going to do is just use my Eileen's tacky. Oh, the whole room is full with art on the floor. make sure, Ro, you go back and watch where I talked about using your art journal pages in paintings. Because you were talking about that. So I was talking to you while I was watching your video. Oh, Ro, you need to do this. You need to do that. So make sure you go back and watch it. Write Marvy on her gun. Oh, you want me? Okay, all right. Let's make it a heat gun. Okay. It's got to go. I'll have to write it upside down. You're a pain today, Whippy. Not really. You're really not. I'm just teasing you. All right, so we're going to write Marvy on the gun to make it a heat gun. You probably won't be able to read it, Whippy, but you can imagine that it is, in fact, there. Marvy is written on that. Okay, so it's a heat gun now. All right, just saying. All right, so I'm going to just use my Eileen's tacky, and this is almost out. All right, another hint. I always say these same hints, and I tell y'all it's not because I don't think y'all know how to glue something down, but I just want to give y'all all the little hints and tips that I can when I do any process. Or is that process, Paula? We love our Paula. Okay, now let me get, let me go around the camera again. I'm going to show you a good use of phone books. Okay, some are small. They're just, you know, they're all over the place. You can get the big ones, the small ones. What's nice about a phone book is this. You can put your finger gluing down and go right off the edge. So all your edges are totally covered. And so then if you're just using a phone book to do this, then when you close the phone book, those pages are glued together. So then you got a fresh page. Okay. So that's what we're going to do here. So I'm going to put this right on the edge here. And it's totally all edge to edge because of the, you know, spreading the glue. Got some stuff stuck on this. All right, so let's do this bit too. You can get... No, okay. I'm just teasing you, Whippy. It's no biggie, really. Just don't email me. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so I'm going to put this bit up here. Okay, and then these are partially already glued down because I stuck them behind her when we glued her down. So I'm just going to go ahead and take some tacky glue here and just try to get all the way to the edge on that bit that's, you know, not quite stuck down. Like those corners are stuck down well. Okay, this one is kind of half stuck down, so I'm just going to get up under there with the glue. But try to, that was the other thing I was going to say, always try to smooth out those glue beads, because it won't so much on this thicker paper, but if you're using like a fashion magazine or something like that, it's thin paper, or any kind of collage stuff you're using that has thin paper. If you don't get rid of those beads of glue, like smooth them out, you're going to see bumps and lumps on the outside here. You'll see those glue beads, you know, those glue rows. They'll pop through you'll see them through your paper. Okay, so there's this page. Still not done. We've got to blend in some things. Maybe put a waterfall over here. I can see a whole little sunset. Some islands, some water, a little world back in there. So there's more to do as far as turning it into a fully cohesive, finished page like this one. This one's completely done. Although it is flashing out, guys. I'm trying to... There, it's a little better. So this one's done. And keep trying to prop it up, but it doesn't want to... stay. Okay, so anyway, guys, we'll keep working in this every now and then. It's just different stages of different pages. It's just, you know, it's a way to be creative, to use your art journal, your color book pages in your art journal, or, you know, taking the color book itself and turning it into an art journal itself and art journaling in it, like Paula and Ro has a version of it as well. Taking the color book and turning that into Hang on. Turning that into your art journal. 1 second. That's probably hamster, guys. I don't know why my family forgets I stream every Monday morning for how many years. Oh, so anyway, either way you want to do it, or a combination, taking art journal pages and putting them in your color book, taking your color book pages, putting them in the art journal, combination of the two, or taking them and turning them into paintings. Where's Paula's favorite? Or taking your art journal pages and then turning them into paintings. So I know Paula has put her name on this one, I'll tell you. So anyway, whatever version of any of that you want. You like the smack and dragon? Now, this book was smack and dragon. It was all smack and dragon through the ink, and then added stencils, collage, some color book bits. And so, yeah, I'm not going to do a flip through this now because I've done a flip through it multiple times. This one I'm really excited about doing. I'm loving these colors. I'm loving all the things going on here. It's another one that's going to be fun. But so anyway, guys, I hope y'all enjoyed this. And any questions or anything real quick? I'll let the chat catch up to. Yeah, planner stickers. Yeah, I let Darcy UK go through all my little stickers because I don't do planners. You know, y'all know that. I love them. I love planners. Don't put a calendar in it and I will art in it. But I do have quite a few stickers. I let her go through those. So, well, I don't think they make the good ones any. I don't think they make these Marvy Uchida ones anymore. I don't think Paula, do they? Or if Paula's still here. I don't even know if they make these anymore. Well, there's a whole lot of stuff recorded. When you get time, Terry, go watch it because I covered a lot of stuff today. Paintings, posters, art journaling, color books. I covered a lot, including showing the new color book here. This one here, The Brothers Grimm. I did a flip through this as well. So go back and watch the recording. Thanks, Eileen. And thanks again for my pencils. Yeah, the new, yeah. And I know I have a lot of people say that, Jess. The new Marvy Uchidas are not like these old ones. These ones are, and they don't make them like that anymore. Yeah, the vintage one. Is it still working, Terry? Ro. It's not even Marvy. There's a no brand name on it. Oh, my gosh. I mean, I don't know. I mean, that's what I'm thinking is, Paula, are these the Marvies or are these? Well, I don't even remember. It's so covered with paint for the past. There's some kind of a thing on there. Let's see if I can bring that out. I think I did try that before. Putting a piece of paper on here and trying to do a pencil test to pick it out. Let's see. Let me know. I don't have a thin piece of paper. Hang on. Let's see what this is. I know it's a Marvy. Where's a thin? Why can't I find a thin piece of paper? Seriously? I cannot put my hands immediately on a thin piece of paper. Oh! Okay, I guess I can't show you because I can't find a piece of typing paper. Oh, copy paper. There we go. It's around here. Let me see if I can reach. Let's see. I know there's a piece of copy. Ah, there's a piece of copy paper in there. All right. Phew! I was going to stress out there for a minute. All right. So there's the thing on there that I can't read. So what I want to do is kind of like you do a rubbing. Let's see if we can read what it is. This is not telling me anything. It's probably telling me where it's made. I'm not going to be able to read that. Oops, sorry. Electric heat tool? Electric heat tool, Paula. Yeah, deli. That's true, Jean. Jean, where were you 3 minutes ago? Yeah, Jean said a piece of deli paper would have worked too. Yeah, I'm calling it typing paper when it's photocopy paper. But it says electric heat tool is what it says on there, Paula. But I know Marvy put it out. I'm looking for any other kind of wordage on there. I don't see any. Anyway, it's old. It's 20 years if it's a day. Yeah, it's a no brand name. Yeah, Paula said it's a no brand name. But I thought Marvy put it out. I mean, I thought they're the ones that sold it. But yeah, it's called Electric Heat Tool. I don't know if y'all can see it there. Electric Heat Tool. There's an L right there. Anyway, well, thanks guys for being here. And, check it out. Gene, are you streaming at 4? Yeah, I know there's a lag. Are you streaming at 4? Mine lasts forever because you hardly use it. Well, hello. Yeah, deli paper would have worked, Gene. I know there's a lag. Gene goes, well, there's a lag. That's why you didn't see it. And thanks to all that watch the recordings, too. If y'all have any questions or anything, just leave a comment in the comment section. And check out Paula, Journal Artista, and Romani. And I don't know. I found you, Dee Dee. I don't know if that's somebody's nickname, by the way, if y'all are listening to me. Her name is I Found You, Dee Dee. That's not a real name because I know her real name. But anyway, I don't know if I'll be here Wednesday. I'm going to try to get Cam and Boo on stream on Wednesday morning if nobody else is streaming. And that's if I can get him out of bed. Seriously, he's a late night jammy journaler. So it might be hard to get him up by 9. The name was painted on the Marvy guns. Well, if there was painted on here, it's done gone. But I think Paul is right. This was the no-name brand. So, okay. All right, Jean. Well, thanks, guys. Y'all have a great day. Thanks for being here. Okay, Jean, thanks. Bye, guys. Thanks again.